So today I'm going to discuss about the Newcastle disease virus. This virus is a pleomorphic and enveloped virus and having a single stranded negative sense RNA, and its symmetry is helical capsid symmetry. It belongs to Ebola virus family, Ebola virus genus, and family is Paramyxoviridae, which belongs to Monogavirales. And this picture depicts the structure of the virus. This virus is helical symmetry, and the nucleocapsid is helical. And around this is matrix protein is there. Envelope is present, and on the envelope fusion protein and HN means hemagglutinin neuraminidase proteins are present as spikes, and in the center phosphoprotein and polymerase protein are present along with the genome. And when envelope of this virus is derived from the host cell plasma membrane, and which is having two glycoprotein, F protein means the fusion protein, and hemagglutinin neuraminidase protein. F protein function for the fusion of the viral envelope with the host cell membrane, and it is a prerequisite for the cleavage of the F protein is prerequisite for the entry of the virus and cell to cell fusion. And F protein is synthesized in inactive precursor form, and it is cleaved by host proteases to biologically active F1 and F2 subunit. Whereas HN protein means the hemagglutinin neuraminidase protein is responsible for the attachment of the virion to the host cell receptor, and it's bind to the sialic acid. So the receptor having sialic acid to the this virus will attach. And F protein and HN proteins are immunogenic in nature. The core of the virus consists of the nucleocapsid protein, and which is tightly bound to the genomic RNA, and phosphoprotein and large polymerase protein are also there. And in between the virus envelope and the nucleocapsid, there is a protein called as matrix or M protein. And this protein is essential for the assembly of the virus, and it is also having role in the budding of the progeny virus. And genome is having six main genes, and which encodes six different proteins like nucleocapsid protein, phosphoprotein, matrix protein, fusion protein, hemagglutinin and neuraminidase protein, and large polymerase protein. And as already told, the F protein is synthesized as an inactive precursor, and it is cleaved by the proteolytic enzyme proteases to the biologically active F1 and F2, and which are the connected to each other by disulfide links. And HN protein binds with the sialic acid containing receptors of the body. Coming to the disease, this virus, Newcastle disease virus, belongs to the Ebola virus, which is having different avian paramyxovirus serotypes. And serotype 1 is considered for the causing disease, Newcastle disease. Whereas the avian paramyxoviruses 2 to 12 serotypes are of low virulent, and generally of serotype 2 and 3 causes respiratory disease in Turkish. Newcastle disease is a very important disease of the poultry worldwide, and this disease is also called as runic head disease, pseudofowl pest, or avian pneumoencephalitis. It was first reported in Java, Indonesia in 1926, but then it was discovered in the Newcastle, England in 1927 by Doyles, and from there it was named as Newcastle disease. And also the same time in India, it was reported first time by Edwards in the town Rani Khet in Almora district. So it was also known as Ranikhet disease. And this one is Newcastle disease virus is very contagious virus, and more than 241 bird species are reported to susceptible for this virus. And susceptible species are bird species are chicken, turkey, pigeons, pheasants, duck, geese, and apart from this, many captive or free-ranging semi-domestic birds, like some wild birds, they are kept captured and kept as captive birds, and semi-domestic birds like emu and other birds which are partially domesticated, and also the migratory waterfowl. And generally, the low virulent or avirulent avian paramyxoviruses are maintained in migratory waterfalls. And the disease symptoms vary with the species of the bird, which species of the bird is affected, and by which strain of the virus is affected. And NDV strains are divided into two classes, class 1 and class 2, based on its genomic size and the sequence analysis. And the class 1 mostly contains the avirulent strains, and they are isolated from the waterfowl, and these are grouped into 9 genotypes. Whereas the class 2 contains mostly the virulent virus, but it also includes the avirulent viruses. Like Lasota and B1, and at least 18 genotypes have been identified in this group. Coming to the properties of the viruses, it is inactivated at 56 degrees centigrade at 3 hours, or at 60 degrees centigrade for the 30 minutes. It can be inactivated by pH lower than the 2, and this virus is ether sensitive and can be inactivated by formalin, phenolics, oxidizing agent, chlorhexidine and sodium hypochlorite. But this virus survives for a long period at ambient temperature, especially in the feces. So as per OIE, the virus is defined, or the disease ND virus, Newcastle disease is defined as the virus disease which is caused by the avian paramyxovirus serotype 1, and it should have an intracerebral pathogenicity index in 1-day chick as 0.7 or greater, or it should have multiple basic amino acid at the places at the 113 and 116 residues, and it should have phenylalanine at the residues 117. This intracerebral pathogenicity index I will explain later. And where if the virus is not having multiple basic amino acid, or it is having single amino acid, and the at 117 position, if other than the phenylalanine, it is having leucine, then virus is avirulent. And it can be easily cleaved only by the trypsin-like proteases. So this presence of multiple basic amino acid is the determine that the virus is virulent or not non-virulent. So according to the disease conditions produced, this virus, Newcastle disease virus, is divided into 5 pathotypes. One is the viscerotropic velogenic strain, next one is the neurotropic velogenic strain, mesogenic, lentogenic, or asymptomatic enteric carrier. Velogenic strains is considered the most pathogenic type, most virulent, and viscerotropic means denotes the hemorrhagic intestinal lesions. Whereas a neurotropic velogenic, it denotes the virus strain which causes mainly the nervous and respiratory symptoms. Mesogenic strain, it causes respiratory and neurological symptoms, but the mortality rate is very low. And generally the mortality is confined to the young birds. Lentogenic, it is also known as Hitchner's form, and these causes mild or inapparent infection. Whereas the asymptomatic entry form, it is considered as that its replication occurs mainly in the gut, and these causes a virulent infection. Lentogenic and asymptomatic entry forms strains are used for the vaccine against the disease. And these are the names of Doyle's form and which forms a mutated form for viscerotropic velogenic, it's a Doyle's form. These are the names of the scientists which first reported the disease condition, and on them the disease condition are named as Doyle's form, which forms, and mutative form, and Hirschner forms. Coming to its transmission, virus is shed into up to 4 weeks in all the secretion and excretion of the bird that survived the infection, and generally by aerosol or ingestion of the contaminated feed and water is the source for the infection. And also the mechanical transfer occurs through the movement of the personnel and the equipments. And virus can survive also in the bird carcass for some weeks. And in all the organs of the acutely affected birds and in apes, virus is present. And apart from this, captive birds and wild birds are also source for the infection. And the pigeon are especially susceptible, and pigeons are susceptible to the all strains of the Newcastle disease virus. Its pathogenesis. Virus replication primarily occurs in the respiratory and intestinal tract epithelium, and through the hematogenesis spread, the virus spreads to the spleen and the bone marrow, and it results in the secondary viremia, and from that other organs like lungs, intestine, and CNS get infected. And the extent of the spread of the virus is related to the strain of the virus. Means the how the virulence level is there, and amino acid sequence of the virus, F protein in glycoprotein, what is the sequence, whether it is single amino, basic amino acid, or multiple amino acid. And already this one told. So if the cleavage fails to occur, then non-infectious virus particles are produced. And if the cleavage occurs, if the multiple basic amino acid are there, then cleavage can occur by the proteases in a wide range of the host tissue. So if the cleavage occurs in the wide range of the tissues, it means that the virulence of the virus is more, and it will be more pathogenic. Whereas the lentogenic strain, enzymes like suitable proteases, trypsin enzymes, are generally confined to the respiratory and intestinal epithelium. So their replication mainly occurs at the respiratory and intestinal tract only, and so their pathogenicity is limited. The clinical symptoms depends upon the age, immune status of the host, and also on the virulence and the tropism of the virus history. Its incubation periods differ from 2 to 15 days, but the average is 5 to 6 days. And this virus produces mainly the respiratory, gastrointestinal, and the nervous signs in the chicken. And the velogenic strains are highly pathogenic, and they cause high mortality close to the 100% even without causing clinical symptoms. And if the symptoms are present, they may include the symptoms of listlessness, weakness, and a decrease in the egg production. Whereas the viscerotropic strains also produces the symptoms of the gasping and drills, edema in the head and neck, and greenish diarrhea. And if the birds survive the acute phase, means they do not succumb to the death, then they may develop the neurological sign. And the neurotropic velogenic strains results in the respiratory disease, and these also are followed by the nervous signs like wing paralysis, leg paralysis, torticollis, and muscle spasm. This posture, this is due to the paralysis. Here also you can see, and the mesogenic strain generally causes the respiratory and neurological sign. But there in this by mesogenic strains, mortality is low. Whereas the lentogenic strain, generally they do not cause disease in adult birds, and they may produce respiratory symptoms in young birds. Lesions consist of hemorrhages, congestion, necrosis, and ecchymotic hemorrhages are seen larynx, trachea, esophagus, and throughout the intestine. And foci of necrosis can be seen in intestinal mucosa, especially the Peyer's patches, cecal tonsil, and the lymphoid tissue. Generalized vascular congestion is seen in the most of the organs, including the brain. And the virulent velogenic strain is, lesions also depends upon the strain of the virus, which type of strain is affecting the bird, and accordingly the lesions will also be differ. And if the virulent velogenic strains are present, then the hemorrhages will be marked, and particularly in the junction of the esophagus and proventriculus. And in the proventriculus and the geyser, the hemorrhages will be marked, and this is characteristic on somewhat. And in the posterior half of the small intestine is also hemorrhages is marked. And in severe cases, hemorrhages will be seen in all the subcutaneous tissue, muscles, larynx, and all other tissue, including the pericardium and the myocardium. Neuronal symptoms is seen as the encephalomyelitis with the necrosis. This picture depicts the lesions, different lesions present in the case of Newcastle disease. Here you can see the edematous form, and it also contains the multiple foci of the hemorrhages. Here you can see hemorrhages on the palm, battle, and adjacent tissues. Conjunctival hemorrhages is seen in this picture, and tracheal and laryngeal mucosa with the foci of the hemorrhages is seen in this picture. It also causes edema and petechial hemorrhages in the proventriculus and cecal tonsil. Here you can see the hemorrhages and the necrosis. Generally, the infection, NDV infection in the turkey is, involves the respiratory system and the CNS, and air sacculitis is the most common lesion seen in the turkey. But the disease condition is less severe in the turkey than the chicken. And as I told, the pigeons are susceptible with the all strains of the paramyxovirus 1, and this causes neurological symptoms and the diarrhea. And mortality may range up to 10%. And the, in this virus is also known as the pigeon paramyxovirus 1. Whereas in the duck and the geese, generally inapparent infection is caused. And a few cases of the severe disease is reported in the domestic ducks. It is also zoonotic of importance, and it is causing minor zoonosis in the form of conjunctivitis. Generally, the conjunctivitis is transient, and it's very mild and self-limiting, but the human may get infection as the form of conjunctivitis. Coming to the diagnosis, characteristic signs and lesions associate the virulent strains gives an indication for the disease, but it needs the confirmation by laboratory diagnosis. And for this, tracheal and cloacal swabs from the live birds are used for the virus isolation, whereas the PM samples, feces, intestinal content, portion of the trachea, intestine, spleen, brain, and lung can be used. And the sample can be stored up to 4 days at the temperature of 4 degrees centigrade, and isolation of the virus can be done by embryonated eggs by allantoic sac root in the 9 to 10 days old embryonated eggs, and from allantoic fluid hemagglutination inhibition test or RT-PCR-SC can be done for the confirmation. Virus isolation identification, as I told, can also be done by using the hemagglutination inhibition test. And virulence of the Newcastle disease virus is assessed by the chicks by intracerebral pathogenicity index or intravenous pathogenicity index. Whereas in embryonated egg, mean death time is used, and in different times gives the indication for the different strains. Like velogenic strain, if the death is caused by less than 60 hours, mesogenic strain, if the embryonated death, embryonic death is caused 60 to 90 hours, and lentogenic if the death is more than 90 hours. Mean death time means the allantoic fluid is diluted by sterile PBS in 10-fold dilution, generally 10 to power 6 to 10 to power 9. And then 0.1 ml is inoculated in the allantoic cavity of the embryonated egg. And these are observed daily for the 7 days. And death of the bird is recorded. And the minimum lethal is dose calculated by the highest dilution of the virus, which is causing death of the all the embryo. And so, mean time is calculated in hours, and which gives the minimum lethal dose for the killing of the all inoculated embryo. Similarly, the intracerebral pathogenicity index, in this also, infective allantoic fluids are taken in the 10 dilution, and 10 SPF means specific pathogen free chicks are inoculated intracerebrally, and they are observed for the 8 days, and then the mean time of the score is given as the 0 if the bird is normal, 1 if the bird is sick, and 2 if the bird is dead. And the score is observed for the 8 days period. Total score is divided by the 80 observation, and the time which score which comes is calculated as the intracerebral pathogenicity index. Similarly, intravenous pathogenicity is also calculated same. And for different birds, the different index are there, like 0.2 to 0.4 if comes ICPI, then it is considered as the lentogenic strain. For mesogenic strain, 1.2 to 1.6 it comes, and for the velogenic strain, it comes 1.75 to 2. Similarly, for IPVY, V1 is also same, scores is given. I will give detail in another class. And coming to its prevention and control, it includes the sanitary prophylaxis, and for this proper carcass disposal, sanitation measures and are important. And in the case of outbreak, the quarantine and movement control should be done, and destruction of the old infected bird and exposed bird be done, and before restocking, 21 days period should be given as the vacant period. Vaccines are also available, and the vaccine are live attenuated virus vaccine, recombinant vector vaccine, and the inactivated virus vaccine. And live attenuated virus based vaccines are given by drinking water or aerosol, whereas inactivated vaccines are oil emulsion and injectable. Recombinant vaccine, generally these are given in the hatchery at one day of age. And these are the type of the some live virus vaccine, like lentogenic vaccine, which includes the Hitchner B1 strain, the Sota strain, F strain, mesogenic, Rokin and Mukteswar, and Komarov strains. And recombinant vaccine is available with the fallpox virus or vaccinia virus, and pigeon pox or turkey herpes virus, in which HN gene or F gene or both are expressed. And vectored vaccine is having advantages, like this strain allows the detection on differentiation in the field strain from the field virus infection. As in the field virus infection, antibodies will develop that will include all the parts of the virus, whereas in the vaccinated, if the vectored vaccine vaccinated vaccine is there, then the antibodies will be will not be against the nuclear protein. It will be lacking in the recombinant vaccines. So when the viral birds are vaccinated with the live virus vaccines, then excretion of the virus vaccine occurs. So the restriction of the movement should be done for the birds for the 21 days after the vaccination. And in live virus vaccine may cause the respiratory disease, which will not be seen with the, if the vectored vaccine is used. And as I told that vaccines, different strains of the these are the vaccine. And these vaccines are used for the control of the diseases. So this concludes the topic.